Hello everyone, once again welcome to RES. In last lecture we learn about the thief story written by Ruskin Bond. What did we see in that lecture? That there was one thief, he was just 15 years old, and another person whose name was Anil, who was near about 25. That thief wanted to rob Anil, and what did he told his name? He told his name Hari Singh. Was it his real name? No. He has so many names and he had habit to change his name every time. We have seen that thief was ready to cook for him and started living with him. And there is one incident related to thief, or related to, we can say, robbery. What did happen? That one day Anil came with a bundle of notes and thief decided to steal it. Now we will see what happened next. Well, it's time I did some real work. I told myself, I'm out of practice, and if I don't take the money, he will only waste it on his friends. After all, he doesn't even pay me. This time, thief decided to rob Anil. He thought that I am doing his work. I'm doing all the household work, other works, but he is not paying me anything. Now it's time to start my business again. What was his business? Robbery. Anil was asleep. A beam of moonlight stepped over the balcony and fell on the bed. I sat on the floor considering the situation. If I took money, I could catch the 10:30 express to Lucknow. Slipping out of the blanket, I crept up to the bed. Anil was sleeping peacefully. His face was clear and unlined. Even I had more marks on my face, though mine were mostly scars. Now I started observing the situation. Because I wanted to rob that money, so I started observing there. That, and actually, I wanted to run also. I wanted to leave that place as early as possible, because if I would do my work on time, I would catch the train at 10:30, which was going to Lucknow. So I started my work, and very slowly I started doing that robbery. I went towards that blanket where that money was. My hand slid under the mattress. Before, we have seen that he has kept his money under the mattress. Okay, searching for the notes. When I found them, I drew them out without a sound. Anil sighed in his sleep and turned on his side towards me. I was startled and quickly crawled out of the room. When I kept my hand under the mattress, I got a bundle of notes. And actually, it was, we can say, that startle means it was a kind of shock, because he turned towards me, and if he would get from his sleep, he would see me and would be angry on me. So it was a kind of, we can say, that a horrible moment for him. So he quickly left that place. When I saw on the road, I began to run. I had the notes at my waist, held there by the string of my pajamas. I slowed down to a walk and counted the notes, 600 rupees in 50s. I could live like an oil-rich Arab for a week or two. When he got money, he started running, because he was afraid also, and he was happy also because he got money. He started running on the road, and he kept his money in his vest. Actually, he slowed down and started counting money. He got 600 rupees. There were 12 notes of 50s, means 600 rupees. And he was thinking that he can live like an oil-rich Arab, means a kind of rich person, for week or two, for 2 weeks. When I reached the station, I did not stop at the ticket office, because I had no such kind of habit to purchase ticket. I had never bought a ticket in my life. So I directly dashed straight to the platform. The Lucknow Express was just moving out. Means I could catch that train. The train had still to pick up speed and I should have been able to jump into one of the carriage. But I hesitated. For some reason, I can't explain. And I lost the chance to get away. Actually, I could catch that train, but I don't know what happened with me. I was hesitated and I lost my that chance to go out of that city. When the train had gone, I found myself standing alone on the deserted platform. Because it was night time and I was alone there on the platform, I had no idea where to spend the night because I had no house. Means that thief had no his house. That's why he was thinking that where should he go? I had no friends, believing that friends were more trouble than help. Means if he would go towards his friend's house, they would ask him that from where you have got money and we will spend that just like that. So he was not interested to go to his friend's house. And I did not want to make anyone curious by staying at one of the small hotels near the station. And he didn't want to spend his money by living at hotel only to spend a night. The only person I knew really was the man I had robbed. Means to whom I have robbed, he was Anil, and I had only one option. Leaving the station, I walked slowly through the bazaar. When I left that train, there was only one thought came in my mind that where I can go and where I can leave. It was Anil's house. In my short career as a thief, I had made a study of men's faces when they had lost their goods. The greedy man showed fear. The rich man showed anger, the poor man showed acceptance. But I knew that Anil's face, when I discovered the theft, would show only a touch of sadness. Not for the loss of money, but for the loss of trust. Thief's age was only 15, but he had lot of experience, means which he has got from his life. He came to know about different kind of personalities of people. He could read the faces of people. So there is one particular remark on that. According to that thief, he said that if I rob money of greedy person, he will show just fear on his face. If a rich person is robbed, he will show anger on his face. A poor person is rough, he will show acceptance. But he had idea that when Anil will discover that I have robbed his money, it will be a kind of loss of trust. We have seen before that Anil had lot of trust on him. That's why he had given keys also. I found myself in the maidan and sat down on a bench. The night was chilly. It was early November and a light drizzle added to my discomfort. Means, actually, I had no place to sit, to leave, to stay. That's why I went in the maidan and sat down there. But that night was very cold and actually it was November and we have idea it is very cold season, particular month. Added to my discomfort what? A light drizzle. Drizzle means drop of rain. Soon it was raining quite heavily. My shirt and pajamas stuck to my skin and a cold wind blew the rain across my faces. When we become wet, that time our dress stuck to our skin. We have idea about this. So it happened with him also. I went back to bazaar and sat down in the shelter of the clock tower. The clock showed midnight. Midnight means it was 12 o'clock at night. I felt for the notes. They were damp from the rain. Actually, he was totally drenched in the water. He was totally wet in the water. Okay, that's why he had that bundle of notes also. It was also totally moist. Okay, we have idea about the moisture. It was totally moist. Anil's money in the morning, he would probably have given me 2 or 3 rupees to go to the cinema. But now I had it all. We know that Anil used to ask him to go to bazaar, to go to market, to purchase household thing. And he would give him 1 or 2 rupees or 2 or 3 rupees. But he had all, means 600 rupees this time. I could cook his meal, run to bazaar, or learn to write whole sentences anymore. He started thinking, if I would live there, if I would be there, I could cook meal for him. Sorry, I couldn't cook his meal. Okay, he couldn't cook his meal, run to the bazaar, or learn to write whole sentences anymore. Now he couldn't do anything. Correct? Okay. And we have idea about education. Education is a kind of strong, powerful weapon which can change our life, which can change our future, which can brighten our future. So see, let's see what will happen next. I had forgotten about them in the excitement of the theft. Actually, I started thinking that if I would be there, I would learn to write the sentences. I would be educated. Whole sentences, I knew, could one day bring me more than a few hundred rupees. That time, after robbery, he came to know, or he started thinking that I did wrong. Because if I could write down full sentences, the whole sentences, he had idea that his position would be changed. He could earn more than that. It was a simple matter to steal, and sometime just as simple to be caught. But to be a really big man, a clever and respected man, was something else. I should go back to Anil, I told myself, if only to learn to read and write. Now see, he was feeling guilty to rob such a person who was very kind, who was very helpful, and who helped him in such a terrible situation also. So he told himself, the robbery, means we can say the thief, told himself that he should return to Anil. I hurried back to the room feeling very nervous, for it is much easier to steal something than to return it undetected. Now it was very easy to steal money, but it was not easy to keep that money on the place. I opened the door quietly, then stood in the doorway in clouded moonlight. Anil was still asleep. I crept to the head of the bed and my hand came up with the notes. I felt his breath on my hand. I remained still for a minute. Then my hand found the edge of the mattress and slipped under it with the notes. Because that thief already stolen that money from under the mattress. So he wanted to keep that money on the same place. Okay. I awoke late next morning to find that Anil had already made the tea. He stretched out his hand towards me. There was a 50 rupees note between his finger. My heart sank. See, when I woke up early, in the morning, that time Anil came with a cup of tea for me and he gave me 50 rupees note. My heart sank. Heart sank means felt depressed because I stole all money. From where he had given me this note, I thought I had been discovered. This time I thought definitely he came to know that I am a thief. I made some money yesterday, he explained. Now you will be paid regularly. This time, see, Anil lied and he said that yesterday he made some money and he will pay regularly. My spirit rose. See, spirit rose means became very hopeful. But after some time or some moment, what happened? See, but when I took the note, I saw it was still wet from the night's rain, because thief was totally wet in the rain. Because of that, notes were also moist. Today we will start writing sentences, he said. Means Anil said that today I will teach you how to write down sentence. He knew, but neither his lips nor his eyes showed anything. Anil had idea that I had stolen his money, but he didn't say anything to me. I smiled at Anil in my most appealing way, and the smile came by itself without any effort. See how good company changes a bad person also. This is the particular moral of the story. Lesson has finished here. Now I will tell you some questions which are based on this particular lesson. This is a third paragraph which I am sending you. Passage 3, there are some questions. First question is based on simple factual activities. Second will be complex factual activities. Complete the wave. It is totally clear now. A3 means activity based on vocabulary. There are some words related to that. If you have textbook, these questions are behind the text also. A4, activity based on contextual grammar. We didn't start grammar, but we all learn everything in 9th standard also. When I will teach you that time also, you can try. But now if you know or if you will revise this topic, you can easily solve. There are some questions based on different kind of grammar. And this is personal response type question. Question based on 4th passage. Simple factual activity questions. Complex factual activity questions. See, 3rd question, activity based on vocabulary. And try to make WH type questions. Okay. If you have forgotten some grammar topics, no problem. You can just write down sentences in your copy. When I will teach you, you can answer that time. 5th passage, question answers. I will send pics on group also. This is 5th passage. And these are the question and answer questions of 5th passage. Personal response type question. Language study activities. Do as directed. Simple activities are here. It is very simple, which is based on grammar. Try to identify the type of sentence. We start this from 7th standard. I have taught from 8th actually. But you have idea about the type of sentences. This is medium level. You know the paper pattern. And B section, which is based on challenging activities. This is writing skill. And these are some questions. Write a sketch, character sketch of Hari Singh using of the following points in the paragraph format. See, there are some points. Question number 3. Imagine that Anil catches Hari red-handed when Hari is stealing the money from under the mattress. Compose a short dialogue between the two which reflects Anil's shock and Hari's repeated apologies. You have idea how to write down dialogues also. Only few students send their homework. But so many students, they didn't send their homework. When school will reopen, that time teachers will check your copy on the first day. So be careful and study regularly. If any problem, ask me on group. Till then, stay home, stay safe. Thank you.